this course, you learn about autophagy, a degradation process that occurs in the cells of our bodies. The course is broken into three parts, with each part comprising a one-hour class per week. In the first week, you learn the fundamentals of autophagy. In week two, we'll review the career and the Nobel Prize-winning work of Yoshinori Osumi. And finally, in week three, we look at the roles of autophagy in our bodies, the relationship between autophagy and human diseases, and the future of autophagy research. We'll start off with a basic overview of autophagy. Before we start to talk about autophagy, I'd like to review what the cell is. The cell is the most fundamental structure unit of life in all organisms. In the case of humans, our body is an assembly of about 600 trillion cells, and there are also many organisms that exist as a single cell. One example of a single cell organism is yeast, which has played a leading role in the study of autophagy, as we'll see next week. Cells are small compartments bound by lipid membranes. And these membranes separate cells from the outside world, providing an internal space for cellular material and the reactions that are essential for life. Cells contain different membrane compartments called organelles, such as the nucleus, mitochondria, lysosomes, and vacuoles. These organelles play distinct roles to maintain or regulate cellular functions, like the organs of our bodies. Cells and organelles are comprised of molecules, and all activities in cells and living things depend on these molecules. Therefore, investigating how these molecules act in cells allows us to explain the mysteries of life. Autophagy is one of many phenomena brought about by the activity of a specific subset of molecules within cells. The next important concept we need to review is known as the central dogma, which explain the relationship between genes and proteins. We often say that DNA or genes are the blueprint of life, but actually they serve as the blueprint for the manufacture of proteins. Based on the information encoded in genes, proteins are formed as chains of different types of amino acids, which are added one by one to form proteins of characteristic amino acid sequences and length. These chains are then folded to make functional proteins. Different proteins perform distinct and diverse functions. For instance, some proteins catalyze chemical reactions that form or remove molecules that drive metabolism and growth in cells. Other proteins serve as the structural foundation of the cell. Yet others allow cells to respond to various environmental changes by adjusting the internal environment of the cell. Like all other cellular processes, autophagy also depends on the activity of specific autophagy proteins. Autophagy can therefore be thought of as a complex mechanism that involves many proteins and other molecules that work together. The key message is that our cells have genes that direct the production of specific proteins required for autophagy.